Okay, let's say you have this state-of-the-art face generator AI, and this other AI that can match descriptions of an image. So what monstrosity can we create if we decide to combine them together? Well, when you ask it to give you a bold Elon Musk, it'll give you a bold Elon Musk. If you want a Ben Holtz Elon Musk, it'll give you a Ben Holtz Elon Musk. And lastly, if you want an Asian Elon Musk, it will. It will. Trust me. It will give you an Asian Elon Musk. Alright, so what exactly happened here? To be honest, there is not much revolutionary technology being developed here, other than slapping CLIP on top of everything that we can possibly think of. For those of you who don't know what CLIP is, it is one of the very recent paper released by OpenAI where it focuses on categorizing images with natural language. You can check out this video I made on one of the direct CLIP implementation if you want. It was kind of overshadowed by DALL-E, but not gonna lie, I think the CLIP would have a bigger impact than DALL-E because of its potential use. So the Elon Musk's above is from the paper called StyleCLIP, which utilizes CLIP. It basically removes the part where we had to manually configure the parameters we previously saw on older image manipulation AIs, for example StyleFlow, and changing the interface into text descriptions as inputs. A good example is, for anime characters generation, there is this existing website that can provide you with truckloads of sliders, and it's pretty easy to get overwhelmed by the amount of parameters there are. And compare that to saying I want a pink hair female dinosaur anime character, then it'll just give you exactly what you want. How convenient would that be? But even if we remove all the parameters, we still have two sliders to adjust, which are the intensity of the manipulation and the effectiveness of the manipulation. Because at the end of the day, the AI still can't visually understand the concept of having a slightly sharper jaw, slightly cuter eyes, or this is just too much makeup. So all there is left for you to utilize in StyleCLIP is a concrete description of what you want the face to have, and occasionally need some prompt engineering. And up to this point, you are probably wondering, why does Elon Musk look kind of weird? Is that even Elon Musk? And yes, you are correct, that is not him. That is how StyleGAN-2's pre-trained model thinks Elon Musk looks like. But it is obviously not an accurate representation of him. This process of finding a representation inside a trained AI model is called encoding into its latent space. So this AI paper called Designing an Encoder for StyleGAN Image Manipulation basically finds where the face is in this latent space, and returns that pinpoint location back for us so we can use it to perform image manipulation. This latent space representation is very useful because it links all the similar features next to each other. So that is why we can use sliders to change a specific facial features, like how you see it in StyleFlow. However, this pinpoint location problem is not easy. Right now, the only available version for face encoding can only perform this well. However, if you check out 2-Minute Paper's video on StyleFlow, which is another face encoding and face editing AI, their encoder can already perform that well, so it's just a matter of availability, as StyleFlow has not released their encoder yet. So we will just stick to this slightly sus-looking Elon Musk for now. I combined everything onto a collab for you if you want to run StyleCLIP easily, by the way. Link is in the description. Tutorial will also be in another video. So at the end of the setup, we can see those two sliders I mentioned before, where beta refers to the effectiveness and alpha refers to the strength. From the input I made, you can see that the more we strengthen and edit, only that specific feature would change. Like the hair color goes to white when the alpha value is 1, and it goes to black when the alpha value is negative 1. For its effectiveness, it is just restricting affected channels by the alpha value the higher the beta value is. This becomes relatively obvious when you aim to edit longer hair while having low restrictions on the low beta value. So every affected channel that links to longer hair feature would be activated. One of the most common things we would see is that the face will become more feminine as longer hair has a higher connection with femininity in the latent space. So if you really like input Asian faces as an edit, then the more strength you give to alpha, the smaller their eyes become, and also given a pair of glasses, of course. This actually raises a pretty good topic about data bias, and it's actually a really big problem that I never had a chance to talk about. about. The AI is accidentally racist because the input dataset is biased and flawed. Okay, but you may say that stereotypes are sometimes true, like how Asians typically have smaller eyes. However, when you get to the dataset that can make dangerous or malicious connections together, like how Islam links to terrorism, this is an actual problem in GPT-3, by the way. Just think about how dangerous it would be if we start utilizing these AIs with underlying data biases. That connection would slowly infiltrate and be integrated into our daily lives. I'll link an article about data biases from The Verge. It's a pretty important and interesting read. Anyways, back to StyleClip. Piercings do not refer to piercings, but slight makeup was done. On the other hand, tattoos refers to piercings for some weird reason, which is hilarious. So in a nutshell, if you want to edit the face in the image, you just need to describe a physically feasible change, as this latent space is only limited to features of a normal human. So if you want some inhuman-like change or edit anime characters, you can train your own model and use the latent space to perform more flexible edits too. You can refer to their official GitHub to learn how to do that, or link up with today's sponsor 27 Stars to set up and run these AIs for you. 27 Stars is a London-based development company that creates custom tailored web and mobile applications for individuals or businesses of all sizes. There are a bunch of really experienced and nice people, and also provide an exclusive 10% discount for all my viewers who are utilizing their services. All you have to do is to include my name in the initial email to receive the discount, and by working with them, you are also indirectly supporting my channel, which allows me to create more content in the future. And yeah, this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. Also, a big shout out to Emdy and many other Patreons that support my work through Patreon. And if you really want to know more about how to run StyleClip on Colab, I'll link my tutorial and my Colab down in the description. Join my Discord if you have any questions or if you want to share your results. Follow my Twitter for my latest update, and I'll see you all in the next one.